Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. We are about to sometimes our English grand finals. Does it even matter what I was going to say? Oh my goodness.
You could have worked that in with the accent, trust me. That would have sounded, yeah.
Could I think I, you could have done that with an accent?
I think it would have sounded fine. You know,
I'll make a mental note for next time. Yeah, but basically, this is actually the grand final that we've more or less secretly hoped for since the start of the tournament. We have the Bench Boys going up against Movistar. It will be a best of three. And I believe we just had confirmation we're starting on Hollywood, then going to Lijiang, and then King's Row if we require a third map, right?
Yep, so we're going to be seeing the same two maps again for potentially the third time now, something like that. I'm okay with it. I love King of the Hill. It is my favorite game type, so getting to see Lijiang is definitely gonna be fun. Hollywood to start things off, pretty balanced map, and of course King's Row. So we're pretty much seeing, I'd say, three of the most popular maps in the game. Yep. Again, this is gonna be a fun one for sure. I think this is gonna be the, as I mentioned it before, I think this is the biggest test for the Bench Boys yet. And Movistar Riders, on the other hand, I think this is also for them to kind of give more credit to their name coming off of a victory this past weekend in the ESL Cup.
Well, we looked at Bonkers and we went, ooh, this is going to be good. And then Movistar went, ha, 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 stomp. And it was like, oh, well, I guess that's a statement of intent. So I'm definitely looking forward to see what they have got going for them. We're going to be starting on Hollywood. So same map twice in a row for the viewers, but get to see a little bit more Bench Boys, and this, I think, will be their sternest test.
Final series of the night. I guess afternoon for me. Night for most people, I assume there.
Oh, goodness. Yes, it is rather night over here.
Bench Boys going to be on the blue, on the defense first up here with Movistar Riders on offense, and not expecting anything too crazy from the side of Bench Boys or Movistar, really. We'll have to see what they actually want to go with here, but I'm feeling, again, I've got to say it, this is going to be this is going to be the closest series we've seen yet. I'm going with that again. Very close one, maybe.
First kill of the game, going to Logix, potentially, if he kills himself.
He's 19 HP, wait. Oh. Nope.
Nah.
Not going to happen.
He's thinking about it. Hey, there we go.
So not quite sure what we're going to see from these guys, but Bench Boys, this is if they start out, you know, their tournament, if they start out the team with their team's life with a tournament victory, that'd be pretty big for them, I think, and a testament to how strong this roster really is. Not only individually, I think team-wise was not necessarily a concern going into this, but a question mark as to how well they would perform together.
Well, the way Bench Boys have been able to collapse has just been absolutely astounding on so many occasions, that with the way they win these team fights. So let's see if they can make that count in the grand finals versus Movistar here. Moving on to point A, Movistar being very conservative, just kind of chilling, making sure they're all together. No crazy flanks just yet. Oh, and that's a first hook onto Fincy, who manages to get away.
That's a great pick for them. They actually managed to get Colsty in the end, and that pickup of the Reinhardt really going to force the rest of them back. A hook, though, from downtown from Kib onto Swoosh. That's a nice pickup. Of course, it's only going to buy them an extra 10 or so seconds there, but every second certainly going to be counting here, and definitely going to give them ult charge, of course, as well.
Yeah, and a lot is riding on those old charges at the moment. Colsty getting picked off so early in that fight, I thought they were actually okay, and then suddenly whiffed off into the corner, into the building, never to be heard from again. He is now 30% behind in terms of an Earth Shatter, so they have to make this engagement count.
Too easy actually dropping to the lower ground here. I'm not quite sure if that was the best move because he's going to be forced back up. He's going to look to get behind him. He's trying to take down Dante, getting to find himself with an easy kill. There's the tactical visor as well. Finds Neptuno, going to be able to find Swoosh as well as he tries to heal himself up in the corner and might be able to get a late kill as well. He looks not quite going to connect, but still, minute 30 now off the clock.
Too easy doing a very good job in the middle of that team fight, waiting to make sure that his tanks had the situation under control, then repositioning himself on the roof just in time to get that tac visor. The positioning there is what won them the fight very comfortably indeed. We're now going in for round three, but to be honest, the ult advantage is so square in favor of Bench Boys right now that it's going to be very difficult for them to break the snowball.
If Swoosh and Neptuno can get their ults ready to go here, it could be good for him, but there's Kib with the hole hawk, gets put to sleep. Nano Boost was also used by Gray in the meantime, so they don't really get anything off it other than the kill onto Neptuno, which could be an opportunity for them to move in here, and it looks like they're going to back off of this one and you know, take the victory and not really be too aggressive. They don't want to overextend and die here.
Using a single ultimate, the Nano Boost onto Crew there at the beginning. And he used it to great effect, getting up to maximum charge, as well as giving Reinhardt a couple of things to think about. We are now into round four. There's the Graviton Surge. Where is the follow-up? We need to see the damage being done here. Getting the Sound Barrier to come out as well. Nano Boost onto Logix. Does he get the kills that his team so desperately needs right now? Two kills for Kolsky and Vincey. Yes, that'll do just nicely. Thank you very much.
Oh, nice Fire Strike connecting from Kolsky at the end. So they get the team wipe from about, like you said, the fifth or so push there. Took them quite some time, but they do it with about just over a minute remaining here. So they'll have an okay amount of time to push through the next phase here. But we've seen Bench Boys. We saw them in the semifinals look so strong on the defensive hold here at the early points of the second checkpoint. So honestly, 330 is... that's easily doable by these guys on the defensive side.
The ultimates also aren't actually that far more advanced now for the defending team, which is good. It's just too easy with the tactical visor. And I say just too easy with the tactical visor. Watch what happens when he gets up onto the high ground. He will just grab two or three kills. But at the moment, this is a bit of a straight-up brawl so far on the street space.
There's the tactical visor coming out. Now he's going to get nano boosted up as well. He finds a kill with it. He's getting hit down by Kolsky, but able to find him behind the shield and clean that one up themselves. So they did actually lose Winghaven early on in that fight, but they turned back with a nice hook coming out there from Kib, who actually was able to save his ultimate as well.
And too easy immediately going to the high ground. We know he loves to do this on Westworld. It's very difficult for people to knock him off there. They haven't got a Pharah or a Genji to kind of fly up there and try and knock him off. It's going to be an excellent place for him to perch on the next push.
There's a Graviton Surge initiation from Fincy. Is there, oh, a huge Bio Grenade connects from Dante, man. But is there enough follow-up? Crew now coming through with one of his own. There's no one really there to do anything. His tactical visor comes down from Logix, and they clean him up, man. Oh, I've got to give big credit there to Dante with that Bio Grenade to set things up, though.
Too easy just finishing himself off basically so he can rejoin his team there. And like you said, that Bio Grenade was more or less the cornerstone of what made that play possible. So very, very well played there. And we'll see if they can follow it up by capping the second point.
Can't poke their heads out too far because they do see Logix has that high ground advantage. He used the tactical visor in the last fight, so they know it's not available, but they don't really have a whole lot to work with either. As Winghaven looking to get his shatter up with the fire strike here, he has it ready to go with a minute 40 on the clock. They wipe him, they look in a pretty good position here, but not really wanting to pull the trigger just yet.
Being very patient, too easy, looking for opportunities up on the first floor there. Sound Barrier getting tempted out by the defense. Kolsky just calmly disengaging, which is the correct thing to do. But Swoosh getting picked up by Kib. The Battle of the Roadhogs at the moment is definitely going the way of Bench Boys. And they're actually getting pushed all the way back to point A here.
They were actually only forced to use the Sound Barrier coming out there from Howl. They actually got a huge block from Winghaven. Props to him for blocking out Kolsky's Earth Shatter there. And he wasn't even forced to use his own. They just got aggressive off of that because of the missed Earth Shatter. And now look at them. They've got four ultimates. Crew getting, he's only 40% off from his ult. But with a minute remaining, you're looking at one, maybe two solid pushes remaining here for the offense.
This is now starting to be a little bit tricky. 45 seconds to go, and they have to make this engagement count. It's three ultimates playing four right now. Both sides have support ults available. And here we go. Nano Boost coming in. Logix with the ultimate. He does manage to pick off too easy. Getting a double. He's continuing to plow through. Neptuno with the Sound Barrier to follow it up as well. Oh. And this is looking excellent. Will they be able to cap the second point? I can't see the delay really being that quick.
Big playmaker coming out there from Logix, actually surprised Too Easy. Too Easy couldn't find him. He came around the side, nano boosted with his own tactical visor, picked up an extra kill, and then came down with the Helix Rockets, able to finish off Crew on the Zarya pick. So they do manage to get it with a few seconds remaining, 1:30 now on the clock. Still a minute 30 on the board, man. That is going to be rough for them to be able to finish this map out.
Ana trying to get a couple of kills there. Gray has actually been very consistent, but not quite able to find the scoreboard as much as he did in that last game. The payload is not being contested by either party at the moment, just focusing on trying to get the initial picks. And Kib once again gets the hook on the enemy Reinhardt. Reinhardt, Roadhog.
Seems to be a recurring theme for these guys. Winghaven still has his ultimate ready. I don't think he really got a whole lot off of it last time here. Gonna look for something behind that Graviton, or excuse me, Graviton Surge actually just comes out there from Fincy. The sound barrier as well, but there's no follow-up, unfortunately, from the rest of the guys on the Movistar Riders here. So they're gonna be forced to back off of this one if they can, but it looks like Kib wants to get a little aggressive with it. They're just gonna back off for the time being. 40 seconds now. If they do finish it, it will certainly be an overtime, though.
I think, to be honest, I feel like their time for that might have been before. Oh, yeah, I say that. Crew actually gets hooked, but Gray has an ultimate. Winghaven has Earth Shatter. Too Easy is about to have Tactical Visor again. This is gonna be very difficult. There's the Earth Shatter. Swoosh managing to get knocked down there, and Logic actually getting pinched, and he gets taken down while he has Nano Boost activated. I think that's it.
A late nano boost onto Too Easy doesn't even seem to matter as he comes around the side, cleans him up with these as he finished off Dante right away. Now, they're going to try to get back to the payload with the change from Logix over to Tracer, but the Graviton Surge comes through, doesn't actually manage to hit the Tracer. Logix able to dive around the payload for a little bit longer here, but it's going to buy his team a little bit of time to try to get something going. But Winghaven coming through with the first kill here. They actually lose Gray in the process thanks to the Tracer, but even if they do win this fight, man, they still have to go through him again at least another time or two. They might be able to win this one, though.
Oh, wow. I think MVP of that engagement from Movistar's point of view has to be Logix, who managed to get the first kill onto Gray and completely deny that support for the entirety of that team fight, and then going on to get another kill as well. Really excellent work on Tracer, extending
what are you doing, man? Colstie charges forward with limited health and just gets taken down with ease. I'm not really sure what he was hoping to do there, but there's the Graviton Surge from Fincy. Can he get anything off it? Another sound barrier from Hal comes through. A big pulse bomb picks up too, though. Too Easy returns with two of his own with the tactical visor from up top. He's going to be forced to back off, and they are still moving this payload forward.
They might be able to do this. The dream is real. After struggling to even get onto the second point, well, guess what? We are all the way onto the third. We need to see the delay. Here comes Hal on Lucio. Have they got there in time? Kib gets immediately slept and rushed by Colstie. The picks are going the way of Movistar. They are doing a tremendous job, and they managed to complete. Wow.
Excellent finish coming out there from Movistar. I mean, they had 40 seconds last I checked on the board to get around pretty much the entirety of that last bend in the entire stretch, of course, of land there to get to that third checkpoint there. So they finished the map out in overtime. We're going to see what Bench Boys are really made of here on the offensive side.
Every time I see the VIP parking space and the goal marker, and the terrible, terrible parking, it just twitches my OCD so hard. Ugh. It's all right.
They finish, no, that's what matters.
It's not all right. No, it's not all right. Oh my God, that parking is terrible. All right, so. Moving into the second half, that was definitely nail-biting. There were opportunities there for Bench Boys to really dominate by preventing the payload ever getting to the end. And I have to say, maybe not getting that Tracer in that Graviton. I mean, you can't really fault it. Crew's Graviton was excellent. He caught every single member very, very far away from the payload. It was just that one pesky Tracer that managed to stall for long enough to start the momentum going. It was a very solid effort. And being able to complete the map there, all credit to Movistar. That was truly superb.
I have to feel like Bench Boys, I mean, that was clearly a throw on the defensive side there. It felt like they had that in the bag multiple times on the defensive side.
It did a bit, didn't it?
So I'm really curious because we haven't seen them. I mean, the other matches, it's been a contest. But they haven't really been challenged that much. And I think this is, like I mentioned, the first real test for them here in the finals against Movistar Riders. But I'm not sure how well they're going to do on offense here. This is a big question mark. Given they threw so hard on the defensive side there, I really don't know what to expect from them.
Well, Too Easy on Tracer, Kib on Genji, and Crew on Pharah. One thing's for sure, we're going to get some fireworks. Gray even switching over to the Zenyatta. This is going to be fast and furious, ladies and gentlemen, as Bench Boys come in for their own offensive turn.
The dive comp in full effect here from the Bench Boys. can it be dealt with is the real question with crew on that ferry. He's getting into that pest spot, really, to be a pest up top here. They find an early kill on the Swoosh, though, and this is a great start for him as they're looking to finish off Fincy. Fincy in a bad spot right now. He's almost taken down. They're able to come up with a few more kills as Fincy takes himself out, unfortunately, here. And this is going to be a super quick capture coming out from the bench boys. And, man, they shut me down with any questions as to how strong they really are on the offensive side.
That was quick. I mean, that wasn't 40 seconds quick, but that was 50 seconds quick. Oh my goodness. Too easy. Constantly a thorn in the side of Movistar, managing to get the picks and the damage. First pick, and then as well, the vast majority of the damage onto Dante to deny them the support healing, and that was the start of the end for Point A. Very well executed.
5:15 on the board here. Dragonblade comes out from Kib. What can he get done with it is the real question now. Looking to finish off the Reinhardt. They do get Kolstein and Swoosh as well, and now trying to deal with the threat of the 76 as Logic's able to force Kib off of that, or rather back away from him. Look how aggressive they're getting right now with the Tracer from Too Easy. They're going all over these guys, and they're looking to finish with some time on the board here.
I think someone made these guys mad. That's my official analytical assessment of this situation, because, oh my goodness, bench boys are playing like they're possessed right now. All of them seem to be on God mode. They don't even care. They rush right in, manage to get the damage, are able to get the kills. Movistar need to stay calm and composed, look for the individual picks, play together as a team, because they're playing against these guys who are so supremely confident right now. Wow.
Gray trying to do something with the Transcendence, but just a little too late as that barrage came through there from Crew to find a few kills. And Kib now in the back as well. Can they get the short spawn? They do get the short spawn for Gray and Winghaven, which is actually really big with 5:40 on the clock, man. Of course, if they finish the map with any time, they finish the map with a minute or more, they will only be the only ones to have an opportunity to push. So the best hope right now for Movistar Riders is to make them not finish the map or 59 seconds or less so they have an opportunity as well.
Yeah, and to be honest, this is looking sneaky. Too Easy and Gray both going up top. They're crouch walking. Don't want anyone to know that they're there. And, standard drop bear attack, ladies and gentlemen. Here we go on to Kolstein. Not able to get the kill, though, as the fight continues. Tracer still trying to go into the back line. There's Lucio, both sides with the sound barrier now. Kolstein still the target of Tracer, will be able to get him. And now we're going for tank number two.
Dragonblade comes out from Swoosh, but he's immediately taken down. And finally, the first hold comes through here from Movistar Riders. They moved Logix over to that McCree to try to deal with Too Easy. And eventually, he does get that pick for themselves. The Roadhog comes out from Kib as well. And Logix maybe making another change. He's going back into the base. He is going to be making a move over. So he is actually, he knows that they're changing ahead of time as Too Easy goes over to the 76. So this is exactly what he wants.
This is looking very deadly indeed. Movistar have kept their composure. They're doing a good job, not giving them too much room to play with as well. But slowly and steadily, we see a different side of bench boys come up now. They are pushing forward as a unit, but not overextending, looking for the individual picks. They haven't got it, though, because Winghaven was the first hero to go down. Wouldn't be surprised if they simply disengage and wait. Ooh, getting Howl in the retreat, though, was an excellent bonus.
This is a good start on the defensive side from Movistar Riders. And I say start, even though it's at the end of the map, because they need to buy themselves so much time right now. They're going to have to come up with at least two or three more solid holds if they want any shot at being able to defend this. But that payload's moving forward, so another one team fight coming out from bench boys would seal the deal here.
Very, very close to reaching its destination. 2 meters to go, ladies and gentlemen, and they have to hold this for 3 minutes and 30 seconds. That's the situation if you're a fan of Movistar right now. Logix coming out with the triple, though, thanks to that nano boost on Soldier 76, and another hold is successful, but at the cost of a lot of payload distance.
Payload is moving back bit by bit. 310 now remaining on the board, and look at the ultimates. I think that was more or less, I like that push. I actually love that push from Benchboys, because they said, hey, we're going to do a dry push for some ultimates out there, but unfortunately, Neptuno didn't have sound barrier, didn't need to use it. They don't have to worry about the tactical visor coming out from Logix, but they have a wombo combo. They have almost all six ultimates to work with on the offensive side.
And this is going to be brutal. Six ultimates plays three. Graviton coming out first, though, on the part of Fincy. Sound barriers from both sides. Second Graviton surge, and Kip is going to get the first pickup onto Swoosh. Again, the Roadhog on Roadhog consistently favoring Bench Boys right now. Neptuno getting too easy as well. Excellent shield to prevent the Earthshatter doing too much damage there, but Colsty is struggling.
Wingaven misses the Earthshatter, misses the charge as well, unfortunately, but they're still holding strong. The nano-boosted Holehog comes out from Swoosh here as he rounds up a kill for himself, forces them off the payload, but they're still in the area. Too easy is way deep here, looking for the picks on the Widowmaker, really forcing him back. It's only Swoosh on the point right now, because the rest of them know if they peek, they're going to get sniped by Too Easy's Widowmaker.
Oh, I like this. Roadhog disengages, knowing that none of the offense are actually on the payload either, so he can afford to take some refuge from Widowmaker. Really respect that decision, but they are now back on. Gray getting the kill. Fantastic stuff onto Vincey there, and the Nano Visor trying his best to get the kills where it counts, but Logic's only able to contribute to one.
Too Easy is an absolute monster back here. Despite them dropping a lot of the guys, he is honestly hitting every single shot possible. Colsty was the only thing actually in his way, and he's actually going to be moving away from the Widowmaker despite having the Infrasight available, which really doesn't mean a whole lot at this point, given you kind of know where they're at.
We know they're all there, man.
Yeah. They could look for a flank with it, but no real reason to, because that would be super risky. And now you've got a minute 10. This is ideal for Movistar Riders. Even if Bench Boys finish, they get a minute on the clock still.
All right, here we go. Earthshatter coming in. Oh, and a sleep on Soldier 76. Too Easy is going to be taking a nap on the high ground. There will be no high ground DPS there. And Logix takes him out. So crucial, that Ana sleep dart. And now we have an all-out brawl on the point. Two nano-boosted Reinhardt slugging away.
Man, we've been talking about how well Bench Boys were doing on the offensive side, but it's possible that they might not even finish out the map. The Graviton Surge comes through. Kip picks up two.
Finally!
The hook from Swoosh finishes him off. They still have three on the payload here. Gray gonna put him to sleep. He is woken back up. Hit with the Biotic Grenade now. There are respawns coming back here for the defensive side. Logic's coming through with the Tactical Visor. Finds Too Easy. Looking for another. Gonna be able to find Gray as well. And this is all Movistar Riders on the defensive side.
Man, and finally, I think that has to be a bit of a sigh of relief as Swoosh manages to hook and kill Kib as well. That's got to be a little bit of revenge, and now we're going down into 10 seconds remaining. The tanks are trying to hold strong. 5 seconds. Howl attempting to get on the point as Lucio does get punched away. Crew is on top of it. It's moving. Nobody else is contesting from the defensive side. This is unbelievably close. Half a meter left to go, and can we see this final push with Crew and Co. to take this?
I think they have it. Crew's got Nino boosted up. It's only Fincy on the payload now. He's going to be taken down. Reinhardt charges in. Colsty tries to get in here, tries to use the Earthshatter. Doesn't matter. Both teams finish in overtime, which means both teams are going to get 1 minute on the board here.
They are certainly keeping it exciting. This is the first map of the Grand Finals, ladies and gentlemen, and it looks like we're going to end up having a minute each in round two. Very well done by Movistar, taking Bench Boys blow for blow at the moment, and they have another shot now to propel themselves into the lead.
That's one of the biggest throws I've seen with that amount of time allotted to push.
I think with the six alts, with about 3 minutes left to go, I felt like they had all the ingredients left to do
it. They seriously did. They had so much time. They had so many alts to work with, and just a complete throw come through. It will be the Bench Boys on the defensive side first up here.
All right. Well, as long as they don't throw the last one, right?
Well, it could. I believe a tie would actually, I think it would go to a best of three on a King of the Hill map, potentially.
It is certainly keeping things interesting here, that's for sure. I mean, the last time we went to a round two, we did actually see, if you like, the awakening of Bench Boys, where suddenly they became this absolutely mean killing machine and stormed their way through, no other word for it, the map. But now we have to see them do it a second time. So this is going to be interesting. Only 1 minute left for each. Let's see what the compositions look like.
Logic's going to be sticking with that McCree pick. It kind of worked out for him, what little he actually played with it on the defensive side, to try to counteract the Tracer, but not going to find that here. He's going to have to come up with some big picks. Remember, only 1 minute for each of these teams, so a very small amount of time to work with here.
Ooh, and Logic's suffering a little bit of damage early on. Azaria from crew trying to get some early pick damage, and it looks like the engagement is more or less going to be full frontal here. No picks coming from behind. Colsey needing to get shielded, though, by Azaria, finding himself ever so slightly offside. Bionic Grenade on Winghaven means he goes down early in the fight, though, and this is looking potentially dangerous for the bench boys.
Logix is hitting every shot here. Oh, gets taken down, though, by Too Easy, who had been pretty much pressured by him the entire time. And Too Easy has tactical visor. Should he need it? He's going off right now. 6 seconds remain. They're not going to have any of this. Tac visor comes down. He's going to find the kill on the Dante. Gets Neptuno. And they will successfully hold despite an early scare then.
He waited for 10 seconds to remain after his tanks had gone down before he went, yeah, it's time to wake up now and just clean up this point. That was pretty last-second clutch, to be honest, but Too Easy managed to do it.
If this does tie, we will be heading to a best of three on Nepal to decide the victor of this map. Of course, it's a best of three series as well. Second map is Lijiang Tower. Third map, King's Row.
Oh, man.
Standard for the most part.
This could potentially... I'm looking forward to this semi-inevitable dive comp that we're going to see right now. We're going to see Fast and Furious, aren't we, from Bench Boys? It's got to be.
Potentially.
It's got to be.
I mean, that's...
Look at that. Look at that.
Let's
stick
like
Helen McCree while we're at it. These guys mean business. These guys mean business. And win, lose, or draw, I guarantee it's going to be quick, ladies and gentlemen. Genji, Zenyatta, Pharah. I mean, you can't really ask for much more. Standard, super dive comp coming in here. And I like that we have Swoosh out front, making sure we can scout for the composition as early as they get that information as possible so that they can make some informed decisions. Swoosh looking, but sees absolutely no one out front. And already Mobistar going, hang on, guys, something fishy's going on here.
Interesting to see the defensive Genji here from Swoosh. We'll have to see if it really does anything for him. They do have Logix, of course, on the 76 to try to deal with that air threat of the Pharah, but Too Easy in the face gets the recall at the last second here. Look how aggressive Winghaven
nice.
Is. And honestly, back out right now. Die, back out, get out of this fight. You still have time for one regroup here. Oh no, Helix Logix had to reload. Almost had it. That would have been a big pick. And they're looking for a pause right now with 23 seconds here.
I mean, this is a pretty big time in a game to pause, man. Apparently, Dante is suffering from some pretty serious packet loss, so they probably just need to wait it out for hopefully half a minute to a minute. I was watching Swoosh go through and hunt down Zenyatta, and he did that after seeing the dive come in from Genji. So I like the fact that he ducked in behind and managed to take out the support very, very quickly there. And you can see Gray instantly switching onto the Ana.
Just looking at the ult-wise, I mean, with 23 seconds, Logix is about 50%. So he's the closest out of anybody to having that ult here, which honestly, I don't know if it's going to mean a whole lot with 23 seconds. So this is going to be interesting. As to whether or not they actually are ready to go here, it looks like.
All right.
It's going to be interesting. So, if they fail to make this push, we're heading to a best of three in Nepal.
This is pretty big. It's a tactical timeout. This is NBA style. 23 seconds remaining. And this is basically the fourth quarter, guys. So, let's see how well they do.
It's overtime, man. Oh, yeah. I guess not. No, overtime would be Nepal. Never mind.
Yeah, overtime soon. Extra time? I don't even know. All right, hang on. Crew almost getting picked out of the sky. That needs to be careful. Now diving in, looking for opportunities to do the damage. Does great job of getting onto the top platform there. And he's actually out of sight, making it extremely difficult for people to get the picks in as well. Swoosh coming in on the Genji, though, deflecting those rockets back up into the air. No direct hit available for them. They continue to swim onto the point. There goes Swoosh. Crew finally getting the better off that. And they are staying on the point quite well.
Ooh, a missed nano boost as he actually uses it. He didn't actually use it on Logix, who had the tactical visor ready, but it doesn't matter. They don't even get on the point in time. It is going to be a tie on Hollywood, which means the ball will be the tiebreaker from hat number one.
I think very few people predicted this was going to be the
the result at that point.
Oh, certainly. I mean, we thought it was going to be close, but this close, I didn't imagine that.
I'm looking forward to this. Part of me still really, really wants to see the DPS players, the too easy, crank it up to another level. Oh dear, Logic. That was the sneaky play we saw earlier, by the way, where they were crouch walking on the high ground. We had Tracer together with Ana there, and that's how effective it can be.
All right. Well, we're going to be seeing Nepal for the best of three, and then Li Zhang Tower for a best of five. And looking past Nepal, or not even technically looking past it, but Li Zhang Tower today, Bench Boys are 6-0 on that map alone. So it kind of portrays their dominance, maybe on Li Zhang, maybe on King of the Hill in general, with that composition that they like. The dive comp, it really favors it. And I think Nepal could definitely also be that. It depends if we get something like Village. I'm really curious to see if that's going to, if that will be one of the maps we'll see here.
Bench Boys, well, 6-0 on Li Zhang. Oh yeah, and for anyone wondering, season 3 is officially over.
Yep, got our season 3 stuff.
Thanks so much. Yeah. Yay! Let's all go buy golden guns, Kappa. Be right back buying Golden Bastion. Everyone's very happy. All right, best of 3 Nepal tiebreaker incoming. I don't really know what to call it technically, but Bench Boys have done so well at having this. What do I call it? I'd almost call it like a snowball mechanic. Every single point on Li Zhang Storm, every single time, they get one pick, the rest follow in a couple of seconds. They are so good at collapsing in on a team, and they're so good at those shot calling in the middle of the group fights. It makes me very, very scared for Movistar here.
Yeah, this is a little worrying. I feel like just because of how well Bench Boys did on Li Zhang Tower, 6-0 earlier, they were potentially going to drop a couple of those rounds, but they really battled back and showed how dominant they are with that composition in particular. I feel like because of that, I feel like Nepal should go their way. I feel like Li Zhang then should go their way as well. I feel like if somehow Movistar Riders are able to battle back and we do go to a game 3 at some point to King's Row, they're still in it. But with King of the Hill in play, I feel like Bench Boys are really too good at that to be able to, you know, pass it up and lose it.
We'll get someone breaking out the golden junk rat and prove us all wrong.
Oh, please, no.
It's going to happen, man. Oh, dear, oh, dear. We have arrived on Nepal, ladies and gentlemen. It is a best of 3. Go on, Fincy. Go Sombra. I dare you.
Not gonna.
Best of 3 in Nepal.
So it looks like, I guess I can agree with you know, the Winston kind of catering a little bit more to Li Zhang Tower, whereas Nepal having a Reinhardt, because Li Zhang Tower, you can be a little bit more divey with Nepal in particular. With the Reinhardt, it's so much easier to creep your team forward with the Reinhardt here. But Colsey is actually going to be going with the Winston. I think I like this approach a little bit better on the side of Bench Boys.
This is significantly more conventional, I suppose. And of course, Kib on the Roadhog, when you actually get into Sanctum and you can actually hook people into the pits, just so much environmental advantage you can use there. So it's a tried and tested, very strong approach. Let's see how differently it plays out. We're going to have to see some very fast play coming in here from Movistar.
Colsey looking to make his move here. He's going to go way into the back. Sleep Dart not connecting, but Vincey comes through with the kill. Logics as well. They take down Hall and Kib. Nice start here on the side of Movistar Riders, but Colsey is in a really tough spot. If he's able to make it out alive, that would be big. Oh, he gets sniped from afar by Gray. That's a good pickup, and now they can really move in on this.
Movistar Riders have to be spreading Bench Boys in multiple directions. As long as the fight is a face-to-face one, the Reinhardt is going to be useful, the Roadhog is going to be useful. They need to try and split, divide, and conquer, and at the moment, Bench Boys are doing a good job of staying in one place and looking in all directions to pick off the multiple avenues of attack rather than getting distracted. And that's the reason they managed to get the point first.
Too easy, almost good to go with the tactical visor. Logics does have the pulse bomb. We'll have to see if he's able to connect onto anybody here. If he's able to get onto Too Easy, that would be big. Or one of the supports is Gray, as about 25% off from having his here. So they did make the change, like you said, over to the Reinhardt. I think that's the better way to go here.
as the charge coming through from Winghaven doesn't actually land on anything. Pulse Bomb doesn't quite stick as well, but Swoosh comes through with the first kill on the Winghaven there.
Doing very well there to get the first point, but Too Easy now coming in with the nanovisor, looking to spray and pray, except he doesn't have to pray when Aimbot is on your side. Everybody from Movistar is kind of trapped on that little corridor there, which means there is no one on the point to continue contesting past about a third, and control reverts once again to Ventures.
That's what I'm kind of talking about here. This King of the Hill seems to just be dominated by the Bench Boys. We're now sitting at about 60% with a couple of ultimates. Actually make it three in just a moment with Cruz. Almost good to go. Looking for a big shatter from Winghaven, though. He's going to try to bring it down. Hits a couple in the back. Gets boofed. The charge going to fail there and gets actually hit by from the side there by Logix, who picked up the kill for himself. It's a 2-for-1 as Polsky was taken down as well, but this is an opportunity for them to try to battle back into this, although they will be down big time.
Movistar are holding their own in all of these small skirmishes. It's just that whenever Bench Boys decides as a team they want to collapse, it feels like nobody is stopping them. But right now, they've managed to get their foot in the door. It's 78% place 15, and they have a long way to go. They have got a marginal alt advantage at the moment, so it's all about the economy. There's a Graviton Surge. Wow, Colty coming in straight away, not wanting to mess around with this. He gets crew and is pushing the rest of the team back as well, and that's going to force them to regroup basically at base.
A good turnaround coming out there from the Movistar Riders. Still, ult's going to favor the side of Bench Boys just slightly here. Actually, big time, as they have five ready to go. So they pretty much a fight and a half will be able to seal this one for him. Look at Crew. He's actually tiptoeing around here looking for an opportunity to bring out the Graviton Surge, which they have a lot to actually combo. There's the Graviton Surge, able to connect with three of them. The Whole Hog from Kib as well. Sound Barrier doesn't even do anything from Neptuno. They just melt them. Kid. They turned a couple back in their favor, though. There's the Tactical Visor from Logix, but he has pushed all the way back Too Easy. Have the Nano Boost, so Logix really can't do anything against that.
Yeah, Kib managed to get the double before he got booped off the edge. That was really nicely played by Neptuno, but it wasn't quite enough. If he had maybe done that a second or two early, that could have made the difference between an extra member or two being in the team fight. So now we are up to 95% on the control meter and looking very difficult. Colsty now charging in, but what do we know about him charging in? Is he going to be the first one down? He is, unfortunately.
Earth Shatter did hit a couple, but really no one there to follow up, unfortunately. He was forced to dive in there. There was no one else to get there quick enough, but they drop a couple. Swoosh comes through with one, make it two. Swoosh, can he be the carry his team needs with the Nano Boost on him? Man, they turn it around somehow. He comes up with some clutch kills, 60% though. 99.
Stagger kill onto Gray as well, and Too Easy decides that it's better off to go ahead and rejoin his team after jumping off the edge, which we can't complain about. It's 99% plays 70 right now, and these guys, I have to say, Movistar are doing a tremendous job taking the fight all the way to the limit here against Bench Boys.
To see if Winghaven can come up clutch. He is the only person with an ultimate ready to go here, looking to get behind the Reinhardt shield potentially. Is he going to bring the hammer down? They have to get rid of that shield, but he gets hooked in. He's going to be taken down. That is unfortunate. Graviton Surge as well from Fincy, and I'm afraid that's going to be it for this fight, potentially the round as well.
Oh, Logix didn't really need to use that tactical visor because I'm a little bit worried about that follow-up Graviton Surge, and here we go. Crew is going to be the one-man demolition machine. Zarya and Rodog on the point. There weren't that many hit points to start off with, but it now looks like a sliver from being able to take. Logix is trying to hang in there, and it's overtime the other way.
That was disastrous. They had the perfect setup, but the big turnaround Crew with the Graviton Surge and Kib as well, man, they just took it back in their favor, and a great turnaround, yet a close one again here in round number one. Now, Bench Boys, one round away from taking the first map of Hollywood, technically.
Yep. Of Holly Nepal. That was, and this is, okay, I realize I've said this about the fifth time now, but we really didn't think that would be that close either.
No,
I mean, oh my god. And actually, to get all the way back to 99-99, after, to be fair, was a Bench Boys dominated mid-game there as well, Movistars have been picking and choosing their battles very carefully. Yes, they've been losing more than 50% of them so far, but they've also done a tremendous job in making sure the team fights are there in their back pocket when they count.
We do see a change up coming out here from Too Easy and Kidd moving over to those DPS roles, and it looks like Winghaven going to go with the Winston. So they feel like Village is a little bit better of an opportunity for them to go with this dive comp. Is put to sleep, though, under his barrier. No follow-up. I take that back. The charge, he gets hooked in there by Swoosh, and they find that first kill. Without that tank, they really don't have much initiation. They lose Kip as well, and they should be able to grab the first points with a few more kills here.
Too Easy was Colsty hunting while the shield was down, but not quite able to make it stick. He's now on the point to try and get an early capture and a couple of percentage points for Bench Boys. Unfortunately, Soldier 76 had other plans, and now it looks like Mobistars are going to be the ones to cap first.
Good start for those guys. No change is going to be coming out. They want to stick with the dive comp on the side of Bench Boys. Still, Dante is ready to go. 40% up. Kib actually gets picked there by Fincy somehow. I'm not really sure what he was doing. And they're still going to look to move in on this potentially. No, it's just Too Easy trying to find a second kill.
Oh, that's sneaky. I mean, he got two-thirds of the point on his own, to be fair. Neptuno's the only person.
Fincy. Fincy barely saves his fellow Lucio's life there with the projected barrier, avoids the pulse bomb kill, and this is, I don't know what they're doing right now. They're trying so hard to go in and find these picks, and they're trading, but the trades are clearly going in favor of Mobistar Riders.
You're absolutely right. Neptuno definitely owes Fincy a drink, mate, because that was about as clutch a save as you can get. And Mobistar are currently dominating this point. They've done a tremendous job of staying on the high ground and sticking together as a team. Bench Boys have tried to use the flanks, haven't been able to do so. Too Easy has tried a couple of sneaky tricks. Hasn't worked, not even with the pulse bomb. So far, everything's just getting shut down.
They made the change over to the Reinhardt, but it doesn't matter. A nice Graviton Surge and Tactical Visor combo coming out there from Logix and Fincy. As Too Easy also went over to the Zarya. They wipe him up 70% now to nothing. Are we going to see the classic turnaround from the Bench Boys, as we've seen on King of the Hill maps all day long, is now a real question I've got.
I mean, the Bench Boys are currently 7-0, right?
On King of the Hill maps.
Yep. So is this going to be the first one that they lose? So far, it's looking good. Swoosh coming in with a whole hog trying to divide and conquer here. Bench Boys are a little bit shattered because Kib managing to get a double, but he hasn't got the support that he needs. No one else is near him.
Crew going to be taken out so late, and I'm afraid that's going to be it. It looks like Mobistar Riders tie Nepal up here in the tiebreaker. 1-1. Winner of the next round will be going up in the series 1-0.
I don't even know what to think anymore. This is all going down to Shrine. Tie on Hollywood, 1-1 on Nepal as a tiebreaker. Everything comes down to this. They have been fighting for so long on this first map, and the next couple of minutes are going to determine who takes it. This is going to be brutal for one of these teams, but
I mean, not to mention we go to Lijiang Tower next as well, so I can only expect that to be just as close here. I feel like that comp just didn't work for Bench Boys right there. I feel like this is going to be super close. It could obviously come down to overtime again here. But I would expect Bench Boys to be able to take this going back to the comp they had been running before, especially on that first round. But we'll have to see. Mobistar Riders are definitely impressing here.
Completing the shutout 100-0 in the second round. Obviously, it doesn't matter if you win 199, 100-0. A point is a point on the scoreboard, and we are now on a Shrine. The shield's looking like they're slightly lower for Winghaven right now, but he gets a charge. He goes down, though, and Colsty is still on the point, now being healed up. That is a crucial shield advantage in favor of Mobistar Riders. Crew trying to make the difference on the side, doing some excellent shields, I have to say, coming out of Zarya there, keeping the rest of the team alive, and they are slowly but surely bullying Mobistar off the point, even without the shield.
Losing Colsty was pretty much just the nail on the coffin for that fight. I mean, they really can't do a whole lot. Ooh, nice pick as Swoosh almost reels Kibben. That could be the case, though. And they will come up with the first points. So it has held true that, if these guys on the side of Bench Boys, if they grab the first points, they always come up with the victory here throughout the entire tournament we've seen. So we'll have to see if that's going to hold true for this round as well.
Well, charging up to 20%, not yet mission critical mode. They're moving around the side. Colsey's actually very far ahead of Swoosh. Maybe they could have been a little bit more together, but he is now back as well. First hook, not actually landing anything. Now an opportunity for the guys to respond. Can Winghaven find something from the side? Graviton Surge coming in. That was an excellent biotic grenade. Winghaven getting the first kill. Winghaven getting the second kill. And this looks like it could start steamrolling. Three ultimates available, not even needed.
Give credit to Winghaven for that charge, but Crew finding the perfect opportunity and finding a late stagger kill as well with Too Easy. Perfect opportunity to get that Graviton Surge in there. He melted down Colsey's shield, and then he just went in for the long-range Graviton Surge. Found about 4 of a minute, and they just melted them. Now they're at 60%. They've got 5 ultimates to work with. This is looking like Bench Boys round.
This is definitely very strong. Gray, oh my god, tremendous there. Excellent sleep that onto Reinhardt. Colsey with the shield down. Nothing they can do. Logix, though, trying with the tack visor. The flip. No, my god, they're going to flip this.
They certainly do. What a turnaround coming out. A big nano visor from Logix helps them grab the point. 80% still here for the favor of Bench Boys, which means they're still in a commanding position.
Wow. They must be thinking, what on earth happened there? Gray had the perfect start to the engagement, managed to take out Colsey with the sleep dart, but Logix just put the team on his back. This guy, incredible stuff.
They still didn't use all of their ultimates in the last fight, though. Is Kib going to be taken down? So is Crew early on. Nice charge came through there in the end on the side of Colsey, and they're going to clean him up, trying to... I think they were looking to get some ults out of those guys, but they didn't use a single one on the side of Movistar Riders, which is actually really good for them.
Nice staggered kill onto Hell as well, just to buy themselves another 5 to 10 seconds before the next engagement. Every second precious now, as Bench Boys on 80% here on the final point of Nepal. They have to regain and hopefully hold for another 20% for them to win. And of course, a lot on the line for Movistars as well. No one's taking a map off of Bench Boys all day. Excellent Graviton Surge. It is 5 out of 6 people in it.
Oh,
yes,
man.
They managed to get the follow-up. Fincy with the double and Dante getting on the scoreboard too.
Is this another Bench Boys throw is the real question here. They do have Crew's ultimate. They're going to have 4 of them up for the next fight here as Kib is on the Roadhog, of course, but they just didn't get enough done with that hole hog he had there. He didn't push Colsey out far enough. He didn't push him out quick enough, rather, because he got a few hits there with the hammer before that Graviton Surge actually even finished out there. So, I'll have to see. I think a lot of this is up to whether or not Crew can get a big Graviton Surge going.
Well, there is a Graviton Surge. We have the sound barrier as well, and Colsey getting stuck, and not really any follow-up, unfortunately. So that is not what they wanted at all. Bench Boys in a lot of trouble right now. A couple of picks on to Winghaven. Oh, and Too Easy
That's
is
it,
the
man.
Big one. But the rest of the team!
Winghaven didn't even get to use the Earth Shatter. That's going to be a Movistar Riders. Take map number one on
snap.
Hollywood / Nepal here. And they will go up 1-0 in the series as we move to Lijiang Tower. But I got to remind you, Bench Boys are 6-0 on Lijiang Tower today.
They are. I mean, they were 7-0 on King of the Hill
they
maps.
They were.
That doesn't matter anymore. Movistars are 1-0 up in this grand final, ladies and gentlemen. Bench Boys are now a map down.
This is going to be interesting, to say the least. I mean, Swoosh came up clutch.
Hooking the nano hog to you, I mean, there are consequences to that.
Yeah, Swoosh came up really big, as you saw in that replay there. That was a pivotal moment for them being able to turn around that second point and take that round there. So, what a lead for the Movistar Riders. Unexpected, to say the least, I'd say, from me personally, but...
That was quite literally the closest...
This is the matchup
like,
everyone wanted.
The only way that game could have been closer is if that... is if... Shrine was 99.99, and it wasn't. It was 100-80. I mean, that was close enough. Oh my goodness, what an incredible game we've just seen.
And I mean, a Village was a beatdown as well
in
favor of Movistar Riders, showing their true potential here. They have to be pretty satisfied with that victory, but we're headed to Lijiang, in which it'll be a best of 5 on Lijiang. It's not a tiebreaker like Nepal was. So I'm looking forward to this one as well.
What I wouldn't give right now to listen to Bench Boys team comms.
I can't imagine them right now. I mean, disappointment overall as Movistar Riders. I mean, what a turnaround from Hollywood. I mean, they going back to that map in particular, they held
like 5 minutes between the second and third checkpoint and pushed him into overtime, tied it up, wins on the Paul. Wondering if it's going to be the same here on Lijiang.
Oh, man, I don't even know. It looks like a little bit of a bathroom break for a couple of the players there. Absolutely no shame in that at all. That was the longest first map I think I've seen in a while, with the exception of the like double and triple attempts at like two capture point maps and stuff like that. That was amazing.
Yeah, that was certainly something here, as this is, of course, a best of three finals. So if we do see Movistar Riders take map number two here on Lijiang, they will win the series and win the tournament here.
And they've just proven that they can beat Bench Boys on these kind of maps. So they won the best of three on Nepal, admittedly, almost by the skin of their teeth. Like, it was close, but they did it and now have the opportunity to do it again and shut out the finals by beating Bench Boys 2-0. What a result that would be.
That's certainly true. It looks like you said, just waiting on a couple of guys to get back after a quick break here. I don't know about that. Lijiang Tower, I mean, the composition worked so well on Lijiang Tower, their dive comp, coming out there from Bench Boys in the semifinals in round of eight when we saw them on Lijiang Tower.
Agreed.
But to see that happen on Village there, and Village, arguably, you know, Lijiang Tower is much better throughout most of it to have that sort of composition work, but they felt like it was strong enough on Village to work, and it got shut down. So my question for Bench Boys is, what are they going to do this time around? Are they going to stick with that and just get beat down like they did on Village, or are they going to be coming out with a more standard traditional composition with that Reinhardt and Soldier 76 behind it, as opposed to what they did last?
I mean, this... I don't know the answer to that. I think it's seen... Bench Boys have, like you said, they've been so smooth, so coordinated with their plays on Lijiang Tower. Each time they grab a pick, everyone knows exactly who to follow up on next. They know who to focus when. It seems like they're making these decisions within a fraction of a second without actually having to communicate with each other. They know already who to go next. They are a well-oiled machine. But we said that it would probably translate to Nepal, and they ended up, they didn't exactly struggle. It was very close, but they suddenly proved that they're human. So there is a psychological effect at play here as well. Yes, they're 6-0 at Lijiang Tower. Yes, I would argue they're still considered the favorite to take this map. But I no longer believe it's anywhere close to a foregone conclusion, even with their history so far today.
I'd have to agree. We are ready to go here on Lijiang Tower, as it looks like both teams are ready to go. And we right away are probably going to see the Pharah pick, of course, come out on this map in particular. And it looks like Swoosh might be going with that one. We'll have to. The real question, like I said, is what do Bench Boys want to go with?
I think they should be sticking with tried and tested, because, like you say, 6-0 on Lijiang. They're supremely confident. If Movistar are simply good enough to beat it, that's a problem they'll have to solve when the when the percentage mark gets to 50%, in my opinion. They just have to go for it, yeah. And right now, well, we have a Widowmaker to start things off with, the starters, but I think 20 seconds time, we're going to be seeing something different.
Yeah, certainly going to be seeing something different from him. It looks like a D.Va potentially coming out here from Kib.
Come on, Logix, make my day.
I don't know if he's actually going to run that here. Crew will be on the Pharah as well, so rather similar compositions from both sides, but Kib, nope, going over to the Genji here. So pretty standard, I would say, from these guys in particular.
Yeah, this is looking pretty familiar, I have to say, to start things off. So we have a Soldier 76 basically playing a Genji right now. Let's see how well this wraps up on our first point.
Right away, no one looking to move back here. Colsey gonna get pressured up as they do find a couple of kills thanks to Crew able to find Fincy and Dante. That's a nice start for him. It ultimately means the first point. And as he finds a direct rocket hit in the skies there onto Swoosh. And this, honestly, a lot of this I feel is gonna be the battle of Crew and Swoosh.
Zoning out at the moment. There was no contesting on the point, and Bench Boys will be able to very positively start this off by capturing the point first. And like you say, can we see Swoosh sort of come out as one on fire at the moment? I feel like he's being driven into a corner, not far his natural habitat.
Still, it's Crew looking for a concussive blast to knock him off. They do see him going to the white room here. Is it enough to find a pick, though? Not quite going to be able to do just that. I'm honestly looking for too easy to find a big flank here if he can. Colsey going to be, there's the flank. He's trying to get behind him for the most part. The recall comes through. Kid finds the first kill, but Gray going to be traded out as well. So trying to battle back into this one, but Neptuno pressured down by the Tracer as well, and it looks like they might be able to pull this one through still.
And are we going to see... Oh, down to a sliver, but they do actually manage to take it out. So 41%, and we have the point flipping now. Logix managing to grab a double in the meantime. And by the way, that was without Pulse Bomb. There's the Pulse Bomb for an additional kill onto Winghaven. And all of a sudden, it is Bench Boys that are being pushed back to spawn here.
That's actually really big. They still are at a disadvantage on the side of Movistar Riders, but... Even so, that was a big turnaround. Too Easy did a lot of work in that fight, but wasn't quite able to stick that Pulse Bomb onto Kolsky in the end, unfortunately. And like you said, Logix came up with a big kill, a couple big kills, even without using his ultimate there. There's the Dragon Blade coming out from Kib. What can he get done is the real question. Finds a kill for himself onto Logix, but that's about it, as they are going to try to flip this one.
Logix a little bit wrong place, wrong time there. Unfortunately, just running off the point immediately into Genji with the sword drawn. Not a lot you can do about that. Point being contested, and Swoosh trying to get the kill. Oh, get the mutual kill by the looks of things onto Genji. Nice lover's embrace there, and the point is going to be staying at its incumbent, which means Movistar move ahead about 61 to 41.
You got to remember, like you said, they're still in possession of the point here, so what looked like a solid lead for Bench Boys swiftly brushed under the rug there, and now sitting at 65%. They were even behind in terms of ults, and still Bench Boys couldn't manage to pull through here. Vincey ready to go with the Tacticizer. Gets taken down, though, by Kib. That's unfortunate, as it looks like he dashed right through him. Still, Soundbarrier comes out from both sides. We'll have to see. Do they come up with this point? Do they get the flip here with about 20 seconds to go?
82% continuing to drive up. Kib doing his best. Only Kolsky on the point at the moment, so this point looks like it's going to be turning a second time. Tracer, the last bastion of hope, or is it? Because we have bought time for other team members to come online, but it looks like they are going to hang back for now. What the ult situation, 2v2, Gray soon is also going to have a nano boost of his own, so be keeping an eye out for that, especially on Kib with the nano blade available.
Vincey didn't use his ult last time, so he's got it ready to go. And definitely going to be looking for Kib right off the bat here. There's the Tactical Advisor, Nano Boost to accompany it. Able to find the immediate kill onto Gray. Now looking to finish off Kib, who would get, it looked like he was Nano Boosted as well, as Gray got taken down. It's all Vincey picks up the kill onto Crew as well in the skies with the remaining seconds of that Tactical Advisor. They will certainly flip it again. Now six seconds, a super late kill onto Kib. What are you doing, man? They're going to be able to finish this one out and go up 1-0 here on Lijiang Tower.
Uh-oh, and if the alarm bells were not ringing in the Bench Boys camp before Storm, I guarantee they are now. Lijiang Tower, and they've just lost the first submap. What now for Bench Boys?
This is gonna be interesting. I mean, the momentum, even in Hollywood, the momentum is carried over from that map in particular, just because of the defense they held with 5 minutes. Going into Nepal, able to make a comeback there, come back again, flip the point, win that one. All the momentum is in favor of Movistar Riders. If I'm Bench Boys, take a deep breath right now. Do not go full tilt on yourself, because you still have an opportunity to win this series.
That's very true. Cool, calm, and collected has to be the name of the game right now. But I have to say, the play style from Bench Boys is also fast, furious, and unapologetic. So we'll see which of those options they go with. I certainly know which one I'm putting my money behind. Let's see if they can make it work. Excellent Biotic Grenade, completely shutting down the early A damage from Crew, by the way.
Kid trying to deal with the 76 here, but Logix gets some great heals coming out there. Winghaven, the first to fall, but Swoosh is going to fall shortly after as well. But Kib needs to be dealt with. He's just getting three shurikens to the back. And Too Easy dropping, not going to be good for him as they start to move on to the point here. Colsey takes a kill with him as he gets the charge onto Crew. It's just Kib. He's going to be taken down as well in just a moment's time as they will get the first points once again.
Oh, Logix. Logix, you absolute legend. Doing an incredible job knowing that Ana was going to be running away and getting a massive stagger kill there. That was very well done. And Gray basically about 10 seconds behind the rest of his team.
That's certainly the case. Kid, though, is ready to go with the Dragon Blade, which we've seen him all tournament long do wonderful things with. I think that's what they need to rely on to get the turnaround here. The charge misses there initially from Colsey. Here's the Dragon Blade. What can he get done? Looking for something. Finds a kill on the Dante. Gets a second on the Fincy, and that's exactly what they needed, man. They are going to be able to flip this one rather early here.
Yep, and Kib using the deflect very well to continue to move Kib back as well. Kib back? Well, he could move himself back. I meant Logix as well as Lucio. So zoning everyone off the point and earning Bench Boys their first cap.
Still, Logix is good to go with the tactical visor. He has Dante as well to get something going. Here's... Oh, no, trying to deal with Kib. Kib. To get out of that engagement a little alive there. There's the Nanomizer coming out, finds the first kill on the Gray, who is just a little out of position. Swoosh falls through with one of his own. And again, it's just back and forth for the most part. You don't often see it. It's usually like getting flips nowadays. It's not something that has been as common as it used to be here. It honestly, it's so apparent that these teams seem really evenly matched. It keeps going back and forth in every single fight here.
Yeah, I have to say, this these guys are basically flipping the point almost every time there's a team fight. It really is to and fro. You don't see too much saving of loads and loads of ultimates, although I feel like this is happening now on behalf of Mobistar. Here comes Swoosh and Fincy, both unleashing their ultimates into the lines of Bench Boys and successfully wiping the team again. They've saved two of their ultimates, Earth Shatter and Sound Barrier, both still available.
That was a great Bio Grenade from Dante following up off of that Graviton Surge as well. And 60% and ticking still. Have a couple of pushes from the Bench Boys as Logix is looking. Doesn't have attack visor, but he's getting... Oh, a big shatter from Colsey. The follow-up is there as well. That was massive. They popped the sound barrier, oddly enough, but too easy falls through with a couple kills with the nano visor. Is it enough to flip is the real question here.
Too easy, managing to match these guys blow for blow, but he will not be able to take the points himself. He does have to wait for the respawns, and we're up to 85%. Time is not on Bench Boy's side right now. Picking off Logix very early on in engagement, incredibly important, because now they have the opportunity to collapse. They have to do it in the next couple of seconds to prevent Soldier coming back, though. Here comes Winghaven.
Winghaven looking for a big shatter here. It's going to be an overtime, undoubtedly. There is a Graviton Surge from Crew. They both charge into each other. Winghaven gets put to sleep. It looks like it's going to be enough, though, as Swoosh, the last one alive on the point. And the good thing here for Movistar Riders is they got 99%, so a single team fight will end the round.
They haven't used all of their ultimates, though, which is excellent. There's Attack Visor available for Too Easy. Winghaven has his Earth Shatter available. That's good. Because the job for Movistar right now is just attempt ultimates out, build up your own bank, and try and win one team fight. They're at 99%. There is no push to win in the next team fight. They can afford to wait a little while.
Too Easy is going to need a big tactical visor here.
Oh,
there, it's going to drop from both sides here. Logix picks up the first kill. He had the nano boost. Too Easy did not have it because it didn't look like Ray was available there. And they're going to be able to clean him up, man. They should be able to finish off Winghaven. They're going to grab round number two going up here on Li Zhang Tower. It's going to be one round away from grabbing too easy calling the early GG, thinking it's over, but they still have a round. They've got to do the...
I can hear chat already. Throw confirmed. Nah, too easy's going to fight this one out. Best of three was only for the tiebreaker. We did have a best of three King of the Hill, to be fair, on Nepal, so it's very easy to make that mistake. But this is, of course, a best of five. So too easy and Co. will have the opportunity now to mount the comeback. I would love... absolutely love now to see Bench Boys come back and win this in the reverse sweep.
That would be the dream for the Bench Boys, but given the fact he said GG, I mean, he thought it was a best of three, but does that bring down the hype if there is any left or the
it was an honest mistake. You'll be fine. Too easy doesn't like losing, man. Don't forget this. I have faith in this guy.
They have to have a big turnaround, though, and they've got to come out on fire here because the last couple rounds just haven't looked the greatest for them here. Winghaven trying to get into the back line, so along with Too Easy. No one really looking to make a move onto the point just yet and get aggressive with it.
Too Easy tried to do a little bit of flanking from behind and successfully stayed alive for almost the entirety of that engagement, which was excellent. He had to disengage for a little bit, but it was very well done. Unfortunately, not getting the kills he wanted, though, and Swoosh managing to get the early pick off onto Winghaven, still with the tanks on point. Too Easy being annoying, but not getting the kills he needs. There's a pulse bomb into the corner, not able to get any purchase on it, and at the moment, Mobistar are looking like they are extremely solid.
They are going to be able to grab the first points again here, as it looks like Gray caught in a bad spot. Swoosh going to be able to find that one for himself. And look at the ult advantage that we see on the side of Movistar Riders, who, again, are going to be putting themselves in a perfect situation here to look to be able to take this third round. It's still early on, but they are in an ideal situation given what just happened.
This is potentially incredible stuff that we're seeing here, and Movistar doing such a good... Oh, nice by... who was that? That was Winston heading up there to try and disrupt Logix on the high ground. Absolutely required there. Winghaven doing a great job spotting the opportunity to deny that kind of crossfire oversight sort of position. The point, though, still 33% and not engaged, but hang on a second, here comes Kim.
Kib trying to get something here. Gets put to sleep, though, by Dante. That's a big one. I'm super surprised Neptuno didn't actually use the sound barrier, but thankfully, it doesn't even matter. That was, honestly, that was a very intelligent play on his side, and they're going to try to get a little aggressive with this. I think that is a little over-aggressive. We'll see. Got a couple of hits into him by Gray for the most part, but they're halfway there, man. 55% and looking strong.
I think if they win the next team fight, they have to be thinking about it. It's so difficult not to. You have to stay objective. You have to go, we're going to take this match one fight at a time. Let's not get ahead of ourselves here. But ultimately, they are on their way to winning the grand final. Here comes Winghaven. Excellent biotic grenade, preventing the healing on the tanks that are jumping in forward. Swoosh gets slept, and no one's waking him up, which is excellent. Crime or Rage now coming in to try and boost the damage, but Too Easy and Al both going down early on in the fight. The squishy targets are dead, and it looks like Bench Boys are going to have to regroup. I think they've got one more shot.
Oh my goodness, man. A late kill on DeGray as well, and this could be it. They're going to get aggressive off this. They have the sound barrier. They have the nano boost as well. Logix almost good to go with the tactical visor. Nothing really going to be showing here. Crew super low already. He's got to get some work done. He's going to look for some high... No, he's not going to go for the high ground here. Sound barrier's out. There's the tact visor. This is all or nothing here on the side of Bench Boys.
Too Easy tried to sneak around the back to activate overtime. He wasn't able to do that. Overtime gets activated once, but the GG's come out. Logix with the triple kill, and Movistar upset Bench Boys. But how do they upset Bench Boys? It is a sweep in the grand finals.
Everyone asked for this. Movistar is up against Bench Boys to really test the Bench Boys and see how strong that roster is. And of course, they are extremely strong, but Movistar Riders, what a comeback after being down big time on Hollywood, turning it around on Nepal as well, and 3-0-ing Bench Boys here on Lijiang Tower. Congrats to them. Well deserved for sure.
I mean, staring that 6-0 record on Lijiang in the face and going, yeah, that's all right, we can turn that around. After how close Nepal was as well, let's not forget Hollywood. I mean, technically the grand finals was a 2-0. It did not feel like a 2-0 by any stretch of the imagination. What an incredible game we just saw.
That certainly is. I don't think we have a result from the third place match just yet between Cyclone and Nerd Rage, but nonetheless, we know our victor here. So, you know, congrats to them. That was a thrilling series, a great tournament. And, you know, hope we've got these every single week, guys. So this action will be happening pretty much all year long.
The grand final, the semifinal was great as well. We've had a lot of good games here this evening, and it's a perfect way to sort of start up the European tournaments here at Rivalcade. I'm really stoked that we got to cast these. Don't forget as well, there is still time, of course, to enter the giveaway. Just go !! giveaway in chat for your chance to win a Man of War headset that is, of course, Overwatch branded. The winner for that, I believe, will be announced at the start of next week's stream. So best of luck in that competition. But let's get back to the games. Great selection of characters, fantastic plays that we saw this evening, and really nail-biting matches all the way to the end.
Yeah, it certainly was. And of course, we still have more action headed your guys' way. In about an hour and 15, we'll be back here with the North American Rivalcade Tournament, which includes BK Stars. We've got Splice in the mix as well as Selfless, an up-and-coming team that has performed really well this past week. So still a lot of good Overwatch action at this channel here later on today.
Thank you so much for tuning in to Rivalcade, everybody. Don't forget, the North American tournament starts in just over an hour, so go ahead and grab some food and come back for that then. I believe, Storm, you're going to be staying on for that, and you'll be casting with Joshy, so it's going to be all sorts of fun and games. Make sure you give Rivalcade a little bit of love as well on social media. They're at Live the Battle on Twitter, so make sure you check them out. I've been Jarasar. Storm, anything you want to say to close out? It's just been a great stream.
Yeah, it has been a fun tournament for sure. You guys can follow me at Game with Storm on Twitter and Twitch, of course, if you'd like to. So hope to see you guys back in about an hour and 15 minutes as well for North America.